dear children, in the last class we had learned up to the question number 6, exercise 2.2, fraction we were learning. I am hoping that till here everybody of you have completed all the parts of the every question is compulsory to do. Whatever the parts I am leaving, those part you have to do yourself. If any doubt is there, you have to put your doubt in your WhatsApp number. Okay, if you are not getting the answer correctly or whatever is there, then at that time you can put your doubts in my WhatsApp number so that I can remove your doubt. But still I am not getting, it means the children are not doing homework regularly. And few children are doing only that much of work which I am doing here on the board. It is not good beta, all the part of the question, it is must to do. Again I am repeating, it is must to do. And the question which I am leaving, you have to perform those question yourself. Because if every kind of questions I am discussing here, then rest of the questions are for your personal practice. Now see that question number, till question number 6 we have done. Now today we are going to start from question number 7. I am reading the question, and while you are seeing the video, you should have book in your hand so that you can see the book and understand the problem, that how the ma'am is solving or dealing with the question. Mr. Vyas distributed cake in an orphanage. There were 192 children in the orphanage. If each child got 2/3 of a cake, how many cakes were bought? Means number of children were given. So number of children is 192. Cake got by one child is equal to 2/3 part. Okay. So for number of cakes is equal to number of children multiplied by the cake got by one child. Okay, if we will multiply the number of children or how much the cake is one child is getting, if we will multiply these two things, we will get the number of cakes. See that number of children, how much? 192. One child is getting how much part? 2/3 of that. Okay, so deal with 192 into 2/3. Cancel it. 3 6 18, one will remainder. 3 4 20, 2 4 8, 2 6 12. How many cakes were there? 128 cakes. Maybe everybody of you have understood this. See that number of children were given 192. The each child was getting how much part of the cake? 2/3 of the cake. Okay, so for that only means if we are making the three part of the cake, then two parts of that cake out of three parts is they are giving to the one child. In this way, many cakes are required for 192 children. So number of cakes is equal to number of children into cake got by one child. So number of children, how much? 192. How much cake was getting? One child into 2/3, multiply them. So numerator and numerator will multiply, and denominator we are not having. We can put one another in its denominator also. Then also it will come 3 1 3. So make them cancel. It will be cancel on 64 times, and 64 into 2. How many cakes required? 128 cake. It is question number 7. Now we are coming to the question number 8. Okay, see that what is. Subham and Sanjay purchased 5 liter of mineral water. If Sanjay drink 1/5 liter of water, how much water was left in the bottle? See that what he is saying. Sanjay and who is another? Sanjay and Subham. Purchased water is equal to 5 liter. And Sanjay drink by Sanjay equal to 1 upon 5 meter. You just don't try firstly in fraction part. First try to understand the concept of the question. Suppose you purchase 5 liter water bottle from the market. Out of 2 liter you have drink. Then how much water you will remain? 5 minus 2 is equal to 3 liter. Okay, same thing, same procedure we will do here. Sanjay and Shubham purchase water is equal to 5 liter. Water drink by Sanjay is equal to 1 upon 5 liter. So water left in the bottle. Water left in the bottle, left in bottle is equal to how total water minus what drink water minus water drink or drink water. What you will write? Drink water minus drink water. Yes or no? So total water is how much? 5 liter minus 1 upon 5. Okay, so in this way you can write it in its denominator 1. So if you will take LCM, so what it will become? 1 into 5 is equal to 5. So first fraction 1 upon 5. First fraction 1 upon means first fraction 5, it will be multiplied. We will make its denominator 5, for that by which we should multiply 5. So 5 upon 1 multiplied by 5 upon 5, or minus 1 upon 5, that is already equal to the LCM. Okay, 5 5 is 25 upon 5 minus 1 upon 5. So it will become 25 minus 1 upon 5, as we were doing previously in subtraction, in subtraction of the fraction. So 25 minus 1, 24 upon 5. Now you see that numerator is greater than denominator. So it can be written in the mixed fraction. Divide it by now, 5 divided 24. Okay, 5 or 4 is 20. 4 will be remainder. So how you will write in mixed fraction? Quotient remainder upon divider. Quotient remainder upon divider. Quotient is what? 4. Remainder is how much? 4 upon divider 5. This much of water will be left. This much of water will be left. Water left. That is equal to water left in bottle. Maybe everybody of you have understood how we have done this question. Whatever the total water was there in the bottle, subtract that amount of the water which does means anybody has drink. Okay. Then in this way, same the subtraction process as we were doing previously. I taught you how you have to do and how you will perform that question. Okay, so in this way, up to here, exercise 2.2 we have completed, and I will try to find the same kind of question. So with the help of this video, you can solve those problems and you can do your practice. Okay, now beta, we are moving to the next topic, that is rational number. Okay, now beta, after that we are going to start our new topic, that is chapter number 3, rational number. Try to understand this chapter very carefully. All these definitions you are learning from the class 5th, 4th and 5th. Okay. So, everybody knows natural numbers. Counting numbers starting from 1 are known as natural numbers. Means 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. When you are starting counting, at that time, if we will say that, but I count that, how many children are in your class? Or okay, at that time, how you are counting? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 and so on. So those numbers which we are using in our daily life for the counting are known as the natural numbers. They are known as the natural number. Second definition comes that whole numbers. If we include 0, means if we write 0 along with this natural numbers. So what this set of numbers becomes? This is becomes whole numbers. Generally, we are not using 0, 1, 2, 3. Whenever counting, if you will say anything, count us, or we will say anything to you that count us, at that time you will not use 0, 1, 0 and 1, 2, 3. No.
generally counting we are using from here, but these then those numbers are known as natural number. But if we include zero along with the natural numbers, then that set of natural numbers is known as the whole number. Okay, and smallest natural number is one. If you can say me that ma'am, what will be the greatest natural number, then I don't know, and you also don't know, because there is no limit of the numbers. Okay, same way smallest whole number is zero. But again, we can't say which one will be the greatest whole number. That is not defined. Okay? Because up to infinity, the numbers can go. Second comes integer.
Whole numbers and negative natural number. If you can see that from 0, 1, 2, 3, these are whole numbers. Okay? And you can see that minus 1, minus 2, minus 3, minus 4 and minus 5. And so on. Up to here. It will go continuously. Means dot, dot, dot means there is no end. So, what are these? These are negative natural numbers. What are these? These are whole numbers. So, same thing is written. Whole numbers and negative natural numbers together form integers. What they are forming? They are forming a set of integers. Now, next, that is after this, if you know and you will be very clear in the concept of these definitions, then you can understand this rational number. Rational number are those numbers, rational numbers are those numbers which can be written in the form of P upon Q, where P and Q are integers, where P and Q are integers and Q not equal to 0. Q cannot be 0. Means rational numbers is equal to in the form of P upon Q, where Q not equal to 0. See that number. If I will say P and Q both can be integer, and this is the set of integers. Okay, if I will take P, suppose I am taking P is equal to minus 4 and 2 is equal to 0, then it cannot be a rational number. It cannot be a rational number, because according to definition, denominator can never, it can be 0. Okay. Now everybody have understood that if minus 4 is there, or in denominator I am taking anything, 4 upon 1, it means it will be a rational number. Yes, it will be a rational number. Okay, these are examples. Again, I am taking second example. I am taking numerator 5 and denominator I am taking minus 5 or minus 2. Suppose I am taking, it can be a rational number. Yes, it can be a rational number. Okay, so these are the examples of rational number. And further, there is no again in this direction. One more thing, beta, try to understand. As we will move on the right hand side in this direction, the value becomes greater. As we are moving in this direction, arrow I am making, value becomes smaller. And for smaller, what sign we are in? Greater, and here it becomes smaller. Here I am writing, otherwise you will be confused. Smaller. You mean minus 1, the number in this direction, left direction, the number which will be nearer to 0, that value will be greater. And on the right hand side, as we will move far from the 0, their value will be greater. But here, as we will move far from the 0, value will become smaller. Okay? Just see, as minus 1 is smaller than, minus 1 is greater than minus 2. minus 2 is greater than minus 3. Minus 3 is greater than minus 4. Suppose here minus 50 is there, suppose. In this case, what will be? Minus 1 will be greater than minus 50. Because just now what I taught, that the number which will be nearer to 0, that value will be greater. Okay? The number which will be greater, nearer to 0, that value will be greater in left side. But on the right hand side, as we move far from the 0, okay, its value will become greater. Because you know, 1 is smaller and 50 is greater. But here, minus 1 is greater. Minus 50 is smaller in the same way. Okay, maybe everybody of you have understood up to here. So, in introduction, you will write all these things and the rest of the things again I am going to explain you. Now, see that beta, positive and negative rational number. We can see that, again, I am repeating the numbers which can be written in the form of P upon Q. And where P and Q are integers and Q not equal to 0. This is the definition of rational number. Okay. Now suppose P and Q. In example 1, second we have taken P is equal to 5 and Q is equal to minus 2. If I will write then in form of P upon Q, what it will become? 5 upon minus 2. Okay. So you can see that here in denominator minus is there. So it will be negative rational number. It will be negative rational number. Negative rational number. Again, see that if P is equal to, suppose I am taking, because here up to there is no ending, I am taking minus 10, suppose. Okay. And Q is equal to, I am taking 7. So what will be value of P upon Q? P upon Q in that case will be minus 10 upon 7. Here numerator is minus. So this will also be negative rational number. This will again be negative rational number. Maybe everybody of you have understood up to here. Again, if, many examples I am taking. If P is equal to 3 and Q is equal to 4, then what will be the value of P upon Q? 3 upon 4. In this way, you can see that P and Q both are positive. Okay. So, it will become a positive rational number. It will become a positive rational number. Okay. Again, if I will take P is equal to minus 2 and Q is equal to minus 5. Okay. Then what will be the value of P upon Q? Minus 2 upon minus 5. Minus and minus become cancelled. So what it will become? 2 upon 5. And what it will be? Positive rational number. What it will be? Positive rational number. So all these examples you will write in your copy also, as I am writing, by pausing your video. And in this way you will. So what is the value of positive and negative rational number? If from the numerator and denominator, okay, it is written in your book, page number here. See that I am showing you positive and negative rational number. Okay, it is on page number 29. You can write it from here. Positive and negative. The rational numbers with both numerator and denominator positive are called positive rational number. For example, I have given examples here. 2 upon 5, 3 upon 4, other than book I have taken, and some examples you can write from the book also. And negative rational numbers, if any, whether the numerator or denominator of the rational number will have negative sign, then those rational numbers are known as the negative rational numbers. Okay, those rational numbers are known as the negative rational number. What? If any one of the numerator or denominator are negative sign. Okay, then these kinds of rational numbers are known as the negative rational numbers. Up to here, everybody of you should be very clear in your concept. Okay, now beta, after this we are moving to the Then what is the requirement of the rational number? Just previous chapter we have learned fraction. Okay. Now we are learning rational number. But can you identify the difference between the rational numbers or the fractions? There you have seen there was no negative sign in numerator or denominator. If means what is the difference between the rational number? Fraction was that if we are taking anything and we dividing it into the part and one part or two part or three part out of the divided part, if we are taking, then that is known as the fraction. So fraction cannot be negative. But rational numbers can be negative because they are P and Q are always belonging to the set of integers, and in set of integers positive and negative both kinds of numbers are there. And here zero comes in the middle. Okay, it will be neither positive nor negative. Maybe up to here all of you are very clear to your concept. Listen it more and more time so that all the doubts should be clear. If your doubts should be clear in your concept,